So, yesterday we had seen key event class and its methods. There are two methods, get key char and get key code. Both will return, the character which was pressed through the keyboard and or the ASCII code of that key which was pressed. So, irrespectively. So, this we have seen. And then the related listener. So I'll try to split the window so that we can scroll through both the listener as well as the event. So bottom part, I have tried to display you the key listener interface. It had three abstract methods defined. One is key pressed, key released, and key typed. So I already explained you these three things. And yesterday I also explained you that when a class implements any interface, it becomes a duty of that class to provide implementation for all the abstract methods that are defined in that respective interface. So this is how whichever class we are going to implement key listener, that class should have these three methods defined. Else it will give an error that the class itself will become abstract instead of. Okay, now let us see the program. Yesterday I had explained you half the program. The program is very simple. Here you have applet, no other components placed on the applet. And there is a status bar. Of course, every applet will have status bar. There is a method called as show status, using which you can display the text on the status bar. So we are going to make use of that method. So let us start with from the beginning. We have imported awt.event and applet, created a class by name simple key which extends applet and implements key listener because we are going to respond to keyboard events. Then we have taken one blank string variable called as msg. Then we have taken two integer variables, x and y, initialized to 10 and 20. Then in the init, I have registered to the listener. Who will be registered to the listener? There is no other window component here. So who is registering to the listener? Which is the source of the event? Yes, someone should answer.
The applet
body itself. Fine. Okay. So that's why we have not used any component name here. We have just said add key listener. Why? Because this is defined in the class simple key itself, which because it has inherited from the applet class, this class itself has become applet. So whatever you have defined inside this class, it is nothing but the applet itself. Fine. So when you say show status, when you say add key listener, that means the applet is itself is registering with this key listener. Fine. Now, then the next method, as I told you, this applet should override or provide implementation for all the three methods, key pressed, key released, and key type. So here we have in sequence key pressed. The parameter passed is the reference of the key event class. Fine. Then in that, what we are going to do, I hope you understand what is mean by key press. That means key is pressed through the keyboard. It is not yet released. So when it is pressed, what I want to do, show status. Who's the status? The applet status itself. That's why, again, we are not using any object to call because this method is still defined in the class body. See here, the class body, flap bracket is open, and inside that class body itself, so the class body is open here with the flap bracket. We have not yet closed it because these methods are defined in this class itself. So we need not create any object here. So we are going to show status. What we are going to show on the status bar? Key down. So key press means you have pressed the key down. So that's the message we are going to display. Then there is key released. So when you, the pressed key, when you release, what will happen to the key? It will come up, fine, in that projected state. So that's why on the status bar, we are going to display a message called as key up. Manoj Dolekar has not muted his mic. 381 Manoj. I will just mic is muted. Okay, fine. Somebody was disturbing and I didn't see that muted symbol. Okay, fine. Here we have the method key pressed, key released, and third one is key type. What happens when you type, or when does this event get generated? When you type something through the keyboard, this event gets generated. So whenever you are pressing any key for typing, how do you extract which character key was pressed? Using the method getKeyCHAR or get, there is getKeyCHAR or getKeyCode. So one of the two methods can be used. Here we are using getKeyCHAR, fine? So as you all know, getKeyCHAR will return a string value. Whose method it is getKeyCHAR? Can you recollect which class ka method it is?
KeyEvent.
KeyEvent class. So since it is a non-static method, I hope you understand the difference between static and non-static method. What is the difference in static and non-static methods? In calling, how should we call static method and non-static method?
It should be called with class name.
Which one?
Key event.
Static method should be called with the class name or non-static?
Static method.
So getKeyCHAR is non-static method. Fine. So how it should be called? Yes, anyone? When the method is non-static, how it should be called?
Object.
Yeah, using the object. So now this getKeyCHAR method is defined in KeyEvent class. So we require its object or at least a reference. Where we have created a reference? Where we have created a reference of KeyEvent class? Okay, pay attention. Can you see here? For every method, we have passed a reference.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is a reference of KeyEvent class, KE. Remember, you can use any other name as well. But then, whichever name you have used here as a reference, The same name should be used here to call the method. Clear? Yes. So here, because we have created a reference key event KE, that's why we are using that reference name. Okay, it is half object only. I mean, it is indirectly object. Let's call it as object now. So that object we are going to make use of here to call the appropriate method. Now, this method will return us the key type. Every time a key is pressed, suppose you type GCC, how many keys will be pressed in typing GCC? How many key pressed in offer? Three. So key typed will get generated three times. So every time you generate, what we are going to do then, we are going to extract which key is being pressed and we are going to assign it to MSG. Okay. Now, can anyone explain the significance of using plus equal to here? Why it should be plus equal to and why it shouldn't be equal to? Or it's okay whether you use equal to or plus equal to. I'm waiting for the answer.
If we just write equal to a single letter, will be repeatedly overwritten on it. If we write plus equal to, each letter will be added after each one is assigned to it.
Yeah. Do we call it as added or any other appropriate word?
Append.
Yes, very good. Concatenated or appended, both are fine. Fine. So what happens is, if you use only equal to, the latest key which will be pressed, like in case of GCC, last key will be pressed was GCC. Okay. So what will happen if you don't use this plus equal to, your MSG will contain only C or whichever is the last character pressed. So to avoid that, if you want to preserve the previously typed characters as well, we have to use plus equal to. So your plus equal to, I need not explain these operators to you, but it is equivalent to that means original message you use and then append it or concatenate it with the latest character and then the entire newly formed string you're going to save it in message. Restore in the same variable called as MSG. Clear? So this is how whatever value you type through the combination of various keystrokes, all will be considered, the combination in sequence, it will be taken all the keys together and it will be considered a string. Fine. And that will be added to MSG. And then here in the MSG, we are going to call repaint. See, when does paint get called? Whenever you want to write anything on the applet body, you call paint. So here you are calling repaint. Why? Because this particular get key char or this key typed is going to repeat several times with every key pressed or with every key type. This key typed event is going to be generated again and again. So again and again, whenever you are going to generate, you are going to modify the message on the applet body. Because every time you want to respond to that key typed event, and you want to generate the latest message at that particular moment. So that's why you call repaint. So that every time that paint will be called dynamically by this repaint. So when you call repaint, where does the call go in turn? In turn, the call goes to drawstring. In turn, it goes to the paint method. So when it goes to the paint method, what are we going to do in the paint method? Here we are going to use drawString method to display the message which is stored in the variable called as MSG. What message is stored in the variable MSG? Whatever we have typed through the keyboard. So all those key combinations together, which has formed a string, that message we are going to display. As you all know, drawstring method requires three parameters to be passed. First one, the message to be displayed on the screen. Second is x coordinate, and third is y coordinate. The data types are, first, the message data type is string. X and y should be integer values. So where we have initialized x and y? Does anyone remember? On top here, when we created a class, we have already initialized x and y. Only message we had initialized with a blank value because we knew that it is going to be modified. So this is how, what happens. The show status, it doesn't require paint method because status bar, whatever you want to display on the status bar, that can be displayed using just show status method. So every time a key is pressed, you will see the message here, key press, or when you release, it will be key up, fine. And the way, whatever string you're going to type through the, using the keyboard, including the space bar, all that combination is going to be displayed here on the applet body by calling the paint method. Is the program clear to you? Yes, any doubt here?
It's clear, ma'am.
Yeah, let's go ahead. There's another program. You need not, everybody need not understand because it's little beyond the level. But then for those who can understand, quickly I'll try to explain only the summary part. Here again, we have key events and key listener. We have implemented from the key listener. Here we are going to see the output first. See, here we are just going to show which all keys you are pressing here. And specifically, this program is for the special keys, the function keys, then arrow keys, etc. So how do we identify all these function keys? You know that there are constants defined in the key event class. Those constants I had already told you about. VK_FN. Please remember, here VK doesn't mean Vaishali Kale. Here VK means, these are predefined constants. Fine. So VK_FN, VK_F2. These all constants are assigned. Now this constant value is assigned to F1. This is to F2, like that. Similarly, you have VK page down. This is for page down button. This is for page up. Remember, as a convention, we normally use uppercase value for this, uppercase letters for this. So what are we going to do here? Upper part is same. We have same init method with registering with the key listener. In the key press, we are going to show on the status bar. Fine. Okay. And also in the key press, what we are going to do? We are going to take get key code. Here we are not using get key char. We are using get key code. So it is going to give me the integer value because ASCII value associated with that key. So that ASCII value we are going to store in a variable called as key. And then using switch case statement, we are going to see the matching value for key. To which constant does it match? So in various cases, we are trying to match it with the constant VK_F1. If it matches with VK_F1 value constant, which is used for F1 key, and whatever value we have pressed through the keyboard, if this key matches with this F1, then I'm going to display on the message. Here again, we are concatenating because we are going to display all the special keys pressed on the status bar. So we are going to display it as F1 in angular bracket to indicate it's a special key. Same thing we have used various cases for F1, F2, F3, then for page down, page up, left arrow, right arrow. Okay. So this is a sample program how the function keys are identified using these constants which are defined in key event class. Fine. Practically, it may not be that much useful to you right now. So the output will look something like this as you go on pressing special keys here. For other keys, it is not going to display you anything because in the case statement, it doesn't match with the normal keys. It will, we have provided cases only for the special keys only. Clear? So this is about key event class and key listener. So let's go ahead from our event, all the event classes. Which is the next very important class we are going to learn is mouse event class. So considered only in the upper part. So in the mouse event class, the mouse event is generated when the mouse is dragged. So there are various sub events, I mean, there are various situations under which this event will be generated. When it is dragged, when it is moved, when it is clicked, pressed or released. Also generated when the mouse enters or exits a component. So mouse event class is common to 7 events. Can you name all those 7 events quickly? Can anyone repeat which are those 7 events? They are there in front of you. Yes, Prajwal.
Item event.
No. Try to understand the question. I told when, in which all situations the mouse event will get generated. Sanjeev.
When?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Did you understand?
When the mouse. Add move.
When the mouse
is dragged,
moved,
clicked, pressed, released.
Yeah. Can you name the events now? Can you at least guess the event names?
Adjustment event.
Nay, it is mouse event only. But again, the specific events are mouse drag, mouse move, mouse click. So don't use ed here. It will be without past tense. Fine, present tense. Mouse enter, mouse. Okay, let's see here. Anyways, to understand individual events, mouse event defines various constants. Mouse clicked. Using this constant, you can understand. Because mouse event is a common event which will occur in all these instances. But how will you specifically understand which event has happened out of all these? So for that, these constants are defined. Then there is a constructor. I will not go to this constructor because these are simple. I mean, similar ones. Okay, then there is additional here. X and Y, the coordinates of the mouse, where the mouse is pressed in. Fine. So whenever you click the mouse, either to move or drag or click or double click, every time the coordinates will be picked. So there are methods also how these coordinates can be grabbed or fetched. One is getX method, which will give you X coordinate value of that place where you have first time pressed the mouse or the current position where your mouse cursor lies. Similarly, get Y will give you the Y coordinate. That means the position of the cursor from the top position. Mouse cursor from the top edge of the window. Fine. Then get click count. Get click count will give you how many times you have clicked the mouse button. Then get button represents the button that calls the event, because normally mouse will have two buttons. Earlier there were three buttons of the mouse. Now you have middle button is replaced with the wheel now for movement, easy movement. So earlier there were three buttons. So this edition of Java defines three buttons. So whichever button you want, I mean, you have pressed, whether left button or right button. If you want to know which button is pressed, you will to identify that, you will use a method get button. Fine. Now let us see the listener which is associated with this mouse event. Remember, with the mouse event, there are two listeners associated. Here there are totally how many events which are associated with the mouse? We have drag, we have move, we have click, we have pressed. So 4, 5, and then mouse enter and mouse exit. So totally there are 7 events. To handle these 7 events or to respond to these 7 events, we should have listener. So which is the listener here? It is a mouse listener. Fine. Mouse listener defines 5 methods. Actually, we were expecting 7 methods. So let us see which 5 methods mouse listener interface defines. Mouse click, fine. Then there is mouse pressed. I'm sorry, I said not use ED, but let me just correct it. It is mouse clicked only. Then you have mouse pressed. Then you have mouse released. Count how many are they? I have also numbered 3. Then mouse entered is there. Mouse exited is there. Can you just identify which 2 actions are not available here? In the mouse event class, we discussed about 7 actions. Which 2 are not there in this list?
Dragged.
Dragged and? Dragged and, which is the second one?
Moved.
Moved. So drag and move, these 2 methods are not included in this mouse listener interface. Then is it that those 2 events are skipped, or those 2 events cannot be responded to? No. For that, Java defines as one more interface or one more listener called as mouse motion listener. So please identify the difference between these 2. Mouse listener is the interface which defines these events: click, press, release, entered, and exited. Whereas mouse motion listener interface defines only 2 methods, that is mouse dragged and mouse moved. Remember, there is 1 class but 2 listeners associated. So both these listeners are associated with the common class called as mouse event class. Is that clear to you? So there is only 1 event class, but there are 2 listeners. Fine. So let us quickly, of course, the names are very, very clear. I need not specially explain what are these methods. Mouse click, it is invoked when the mouse is pressed and released at the same point. That means when you click is a combination of pressed and released together. So it's not like key press and key released. Mouse click is a common. Of course, there are other 2 events also, pressed and released. But when you talk about click, it is a combination of both. When both the situations have occurred, or when both the actions have occurred, that is pressed and released, that time clicked event gets generated. So there are situations, if you have defined clicked also and released also, that released and clicked, many of the times, both these events get generated simultaneously. Fine. Why? Because you have pressed and then released. That means it is equivalent to mouse click. So mouse click, this event also happens, and released also happens. Then mouse entered. Mouse entered happens when the mouse cursor enters the component, whichever component you are going to use to respond to the event. So whenever the cursor enters that component or moved upon that component, mouse entered happens. Like for example, now my window, my mouse cursor, I have taken it outside this document window. So can you see your cursor here? Cursor in the arrow shape. So now when I take it inside, my cursor changes its shape from arrowhead to I value. By I indicating we are in insert mode, I can just click anywhere and I can modify this text. To indicate that, the cursor shape automatically changes. So this is mouse entered event. Similarly, now I'm just going to do mouse exit. So can you see the cursor movement? I'm slowly taking it outside this document area. The moment exit happens, mouse exited, that event gets generated. My cursor changes its shape from I to arrowhead again. So this is how mouse entered and exited happen. Mouse dragged and mouse moved. I had already told you the difference. Move happens now. I mean, I'm just moving the cursor. But drag will happen when I have kept the mouse button pressed and I'm trying to move the mouse in that pressed position. Normally, I press the left mouse button. So mouse drag happens when the whenever I have pressed and dragged. So remember, mouse drag happen every time I change a place. So I'm dragging from this end to that end. In that, this mouse drag event is called multiple times as the mouse drag. For every coordinate value, for every pixel value, this mouse drag will be repeatedly called. Similarly, mouse move also will be repeatedly called. Fine. So there is one more program which is associated with these mouse events as well that we'll discuss in the next class. Now you can ask any doubts if you have, or you can just give your attendance. And if you don't have doubts, you can just leave the meeting.